and welcome for the fourth practical session of the debate education enhancement program. Today, as usual, we have a debate session, and then we have an opposing team here at the left, and we have proposing team at the right. So, before we are going to start the actual debate, let me just tell you some guidelines you need to remind during your debate. The first thing, you have a total of maybe 18 minutes plus 3, and finally you have I think 26 minutes to finish this session. The speaker will have 3 minutes, and then the last speaker will have another 3 minutes, just to summarize. Then each speaker will have 3 minutes. But if you want, just you can make it 4. If you have an extended issue, and probably just let's make it 4 for individuals and 3 for summary. So each speaker will have 4 minutes. Then the last speaker who is going to summarize the team issue or the team idea will have 3 minutes. So if you have a point of information, you will raise your hand, or simply you can say point of information after the speaker, which is 1 minute. And then before 30 minutes left to finish. So between 1 minute and 30 minutes before the end of his or her speech. And always you have to remind how you are helping your opponents, and then you also give it fast for your points. Perhaps we judges or educators at the back, therefore they will evaluate your stance, how you are battled, and also your manner will be considered to win this debate. So, as usual, or as a rule, the first chance is going to be given for the first speakers of the opposition team. And then she is going to just introduce herself and then her friend, then she will also just come up with some definitions. Thank you. Thank you. question here. So why don't you just give a chance for the first because of that of question? First speaker of opposition. Now the chance is given to the second speaker of the proposition. But as much as possible, try to use your maximum time. I didn't say the first speaker's responsibility is simply just introducing or giving a definition. Rather, you have to also just give some highlights or some strong points which can substantiate your point. Before just analysis is passed, let's just look at some more from the second speaker. The floor is open for you.
Okay, thank you. My name is Sarah Mahir. I'm from the proposition group. We support the idea that the host believes that the speech should be absolutely free. Of course, the speech should be absolutely free because it's a principle that supports freedom of an individual. We should see it's a freedom of an individual. It's the principle that supports freedom of an individual. So, if we want to support the freedom of an individual, we should allow an individual to express their feelings freely, and it allows free citizens to become an individual, to become individual, and it gives them a sense of ownership in their country. If we give them the right to express their feelings freely, they can say anything they want to the government who oppress the citizens. So they can make a country, a democratic country, with a feeling of ownership in their country. The other is, it's easier to make new discoveries and gain new knowledge when you can suggest ideas and exchange information freely. When we can say something freely, we can hear something freely. When people express their feelings freely, when we can express our feelings freely, we can tell our ideas, any ideas that we want. So even if the idea is wrong, we can trace to the truth. We can find the truth even if we are wrong. So
we deserve to know every nasty thought that comes into your mind.
We can reject it, but it should not be restricted by law. It should not be. It should not have a legal sanction because it should not have a legal sanction because if citizens are restricted not to speak freely, they will fear a sanction and they will not express their feelings freely. Suppress or oppress citizens, there won't be a democratic country because the basic features of a democratic country is to give their citizens a freedom of speech. The other is if a country is a democratic country, they give the country gives democracy a right, freedom of speech for the citizens because it's a basic principle of any democratic country. And when they have a freedom of speech, they can fight for their freedom. If any person don't have a freedom of speech in the first place, they cannot fight for another freedom. They cannot fight for their democratic right. But if we give them a freedom of speech, they can say anything they want, and they can have their rights respected. If there is no freedom of speech, a government can suppress the citizens, and no one and nobody can fight for citizens' rights. Thank you.
The opposition for your present speech, not for the second speaker of the opposition.
One opposition team. I just want to say first, they are avoiding the term absolutely free every time they make a speech. They are avoiding it because there's no absolute freedom. There's no absolute freedom of speech. there's no absolute freedom of anything. Why? Because we do not need to know every nasty thought that crawls into your mind. Absolute freedom is giving absolute freedom of speech to everyone, meaning ISIS also, meaning racist people, meaning nationalists. We don't need to know their opinion. And you said something about government, and if people don't, we are not saying people should not be free. We are saying people should not be absolutely free to express their opinions. First of all, yes, personal opinions come to this when we say absolute freedom. It means I can personally offend him, because if I have the freedom to offend him, to make him feel uncomfortable, because to what I speak, because that's absolute freedom. Should I insult you? Should I just offend you with what I say? Should I give you nasty comments on your race, your sexuality, your beliefs? That's what absolute freedom is.
Okay, I'll take that point of information. Did you say that it's because just because some people have bad ideas of insulting people or saying racist things to people, that all people should be, all people's freedom should be restricted?
Yeah, you are still avoiding absolute freedom. We are against absolute freedom, not freedom. People should express their opinions, but not everything that comes into their mind, not everything should be put. And it's not even in our body. We should keep some things inside, and some things are better unspoken. That's what our team believes, right? Some things are better unspoken.
If there's another point of information, I'll take it. What things should be allowed, what things should be restricted, to say there shouldn't be absolute freedom?
What should be restricted?
Yeah,
I feel like ISIS should be restricted from spreading their poisonous ideas. I feel like nationalists should stop poisoning our youngs. I believe that racist people should stop giving racist comments. Should I sit down?
No.
We believe they should stop that, and we believe the law should restrict them from saying those things, from poisoning the youngs, even from poisoning even old people, like people, because it's opinions. It can crawl into your mind and fest and make something huge inside of you. It can hurt us. It can break our hearts, right? Words are strong, and they can break hearts. They can break spirits, and they can break communities. So there should be a restriction. We're not saying freedom should be taken away, but there should be a limitation in our freedom. Thank you.
Thank you, speaker, for the question, for your interesting presentation. Now the chance to move for the last part of the opposition. The proposition, sorry.
Okay, guys, thank you for giving this chance. And last week, that president should be absolutely. And as my friend is the given speech, our speech, and the speech is ability to speak or to use vocal communication. And it's the main advocate of power functional vocal communication. And let me explain something about freedom of speech. And freedom of speech is the power or right to express one opinion without any censorship or trace of legal personalities. And as our constitution, Article 29, says that the right of let me speak is not being related to state by state. The Article 29 says that the right of thought, opinion, and expression. Everyone has the sub-article says that everyone has the right to speak, the right to freedom of expression without any interference, just underlining the word any interference. And the right that shall include freedom to speak, receive, report, and information, and the idea of all kinds, regardless. Process, either orally in writing or in English. Let me explain what this means. Okay? You said that if you have the absolute right, you think that I can dissent to say this, right? So if I have to dissent to you, I will do it. If I have to. This is my point of view. in my opinion. So I can show you that aspects, right? Okay, so if you express bad things, or if I see a bad things for you, I can insult you in order to just rearrange your opinions, re-express your what you are saying in the UK.
Human must express their opinion without any interference. But what kind of expression? What kind of expression?
Any expressions which are important for the community, which are important for security, and which are important for the society, and it's just absolutely.
What about that?
Anyways, let's give a chance for the last case of the question.
Everyone can express their opinion without human interference. Sometimes opinion may be different because someone may disgrace someone, some companies without minor reason. It may be personal problem. They may disgrace their name. This may lead to a big punishment. Let's come to my point. If it is absolute or unlimited, it may test someone's humanity. It may abuse their morality. They may give false comments. Someone may give false comments about something or a company's discovers company lose something because of this. Okay.
If you are restricted, you just then you test out your country or they think customers.
We are not restricting the right of the speech, but we are just talking about the free expression. Human may express something abusiveness or something usefulness. We are just talking about someone may disgrace someone's humanity. So it may be because of this, the speech may be absolutely may not be absolute. Because absolute free speech, someone can disgrace someone's name because of personal problem. Sometimes there may be unlawful expression about someone. There must be limited.
Do you think that the word limiting freedom of speech, if freedom by itself can go together, but freedom is having a freedom, and we cannot be limited in expressing the freedom of speech. If we say freedom of speech, it by itself expresses that it's absolute. So we cannot say do you think that we can say limitation?
Okay, let me answer my question. What if that expression is unlawful? What if we are not restricting the expression, right? We are expression must be limited in some way. If it is unlawful, what do you do? If it is unlawful.
Okay, Kevin, let's just read the test with this condition. It's just so tough. So now I think we have finished the first part, and the chance will be given one for one group, just sum up the general points of the activity. So the chance is going to be for the first, the ones because of the opposition, because it's vice versa for the same part.
I think they just wanted to bully my friend with the word limitation. I can explain limitation. You are allowed to move around Ethiopia, but once you're found in Sudan, they can shoot you down. That's what limitation means. You are free in your zone, but once you get
out of that zone, you're not free. And they said something about the constitution and how it's giving us the freedom to say anything we want, anyone we want, anywhere, wherever. That's not true, because at the same time, their crime law prevents you from saying whatever you want to say to someone, because if you insult me, I can sue you and you can get arrested from six months to up to 1 year. So it's just work on your law. I think you guys are law students. Work on the law. And the last one, the speech should not be absolutely free. It should not be absolutely free, because speech has the power to make and break people. I think there's a saying that I forgot it, so let's just move on. But speech can make us and can break us. And if someone says something encouragement to me, that can make my day. If someone insults me, that can ruin my life, maybe even my life. So there should be a restriction on freedom of speech, or there should be a limitation on what we say. Strongly believes that.
The question for your Sama, and then the floor is open for the last part of the proposition.
We again would say that we support the idea that freedom of speech should be absolute, because if we are talking about restricting or limiting free speech, we should say the speech should be limited. We cannot say freedom of speech should be limited, because it says freedom and it cannot go with the word limitation. There's an example she gave when there's a room to bear, we have freedom to stay in Tokyo, and we can be sure the way we go to the. But if we have freedom of speech, the constitution gave us a freedom to move in Ethiopia, we should stay in Ethiopia in the very first place. It has nothing to do with the limitation, because it is just staying in Ethiopia, and we know that our right is only in Ethiopia. It works only in Ethiopia, because we are citizens of Ethiopia. And we cannot go to Sudan and ask for some rights in the constitution of Ethiopia to do something for us. So, freedom of speech and limiting speech cannot go together. So freedom of speech means by itself giving an absolute freedom to speak anything that we want. And if we oppress by our, if we say something bad to people by our borders, if we make them feel bad, it's just our laws. They can say bad things to us, but so they can defend themselves by their borders, and we can defend by our borders. So I think our team thinks that freedom of speech should be absolute. Thank you.
Great. It's just the end of the message. Now let's give some time for just the environment. Your debate and just verify who's going to be the winner of today's session. So just stay calm. And like this after practice, then we have a lot of quite information about many kinds of people. So today's that is tough, and I like it much. Thank you.
Sorry, today I couldn't bring the banner, which is already prepared for the sessions, because it's locked in one room, and then the keys lost. We just lose the key. Probably that's, we will change it, and we'll bring the banner for our next session. The judges, have you finished? If you finish, just take the stage and then notify us who is the winner of today's session. They are in another debate. To be honest, I have seen a lot of improvements on your debating, so that's why we need, and probably we're going to have a lot of experiences and a lot of practice sessions. Hopefully, you will just show your actual performance, which lets you to be representative for your university. Can we make the announcement for next session?
Good morning again.
Would you just come to the front, please, and to the stage? Introduce yourself and your role also.
Okay, I'm Anja from the chat group. I'm one of the judges, and it was a good sharing of ideas and debates. And we have some characters to just to characterize you. And the first thing is that eye contact. Like you were not giving us eye contact at the Zoom group, but you were just like reading the page. And some of you from the proposition group also have this defect when you're eye contacting with the judges or with the audience. And the second thing is that time management was good on the proposition group. And when we see supporting your audience group's ideas or fallacy of ideas, where it was like we're seeing fallacy of ideas on the opposition group. And some of the proposition group also, you were like on their side, and some of you were like passing your ideas. And the third one was like using their time wisely. The proposition group will use their time wisely. But finally, the group part of the today's debate is.
Is she is suspended as
it's hard to decide, but like we just give you points on like 51.6 and 51.7, so the opposition group has won the points.
Give your hand to them.